Hello, welcome this evening again, everybody. Tonight it's just going to be much about church, how we're going to be doing what we're doing with church now. Like I said, it's not going to be business. As usual, and tonight, yes, come. I have somebody who by the special grace of God, it's savvy when it comes to all this technology. I've seen him over the years doing this. And it's my pleasure to have him with us tonight, and that's Pastor Leke Adeboye. It's here. You're welcome, sir.
My father.
It's an honor to have you here, sir.
It's a privilege, sir. Once Papa messages me. The one and only Papa in our CCG. As you come online, even at 2 a.m., I will fall in, sir.
I don't know about that, sir. When your boss is calling you, father, then you can be in trouble if you are not careful. So I don't want to be in trouble, sir. Again, you're welcome, sir. You're welcome.
Thank you, sir. Now, thank you, sir.
For those of us who are joining us on this platform, I want to welcome you. This great man of God, the reason why I'm bringing him, I'm just going to explain to him. It's a man of many parts. How he has been able to juggle all those arts together, I don't know. I work with him, and sometimes he's my brother, and I mean blood brother, but again, I work with him in amazement as where he has BSc in aerospace engineering, he has master's in project management. It's a pilot, it's a businessman globally. It's a security expert, it's an executive protection personnel, executive is into training. It's a pastor, then worldwide, he leads a group within the Redeemed Christian Church of God, which is Pastor Seed Forum, is the head, is the visionaire. Mm-hmm. And that is spreading like fire all around the world. Seems to be like the next generation of leaders grooming them. And at the same time, he is the worldwide, all around the world, SPA to the general overseer. Now, when I see that title, my own title becomes very, very easy. He's a special personal assistant to the general overseer. I am this special personal assistant to
Pastor. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for the honor and the privilege, sir. I'm just your boy. I'm just a humble messenger, you know, sir.
I'm the boy of the messenger, sir. Okay, sir. When it comes to futurist thinking, I will regard myself as one of the few people who is, one of the people who fall into that category. But more often than not, when I see you in action, I feel that I'm possibly not there, or I'm trying to latch on the thing. And one of the reasons why I'm bringing you tonight is this, sir. When this whole COVID started, I started a 21 days praying and fasting as an intercessor. Mm-hmm. And all we did then was just praying against COVID. We get the numbers of deaths, the number of cases, and we are praying, trusting God that this number will go down. We did that for 21 days. And after 21 days, the next thing I did was to ask post-COVID. When we're talking about post-COVID, we talked about which some of the things I share with you at the initial stage. The property market all around the world is going to change. The stock market is going to change. So I put all the figures that all the governments are putting into different things all around the world, the $200 billion by Bank of England, the $708 billion by European Central Bank, and all the figures. We postulate it and say, look, this is what is happening now. The government is trying to jumpstart the economy. This is where it's going to be leading to. in the nest again to help people to position themselves for investment. And after that, we did career, as in today, it's a lost job, no doubt about it, all around the world.
Yeah.
A lot of companies are going to go into reception. So we now did a topic that, look, listing, what's the next phase of career? So that people, again, can get themselves ready. Now, we finished that. This week, I just thought, okay, you know what? Can we just take it now? We deal with the individual. Can we take it to church? As in, I know that the church is never going to be the same again. It's not, there's no, it's not a rocket science. There's a shift in the church. And the thing about the world is that once whatever the world moves away from, they don't move back to it. So it will be a cheap blessing for anybody thinking we're going to have the church back to what it is. I was talking to my minister on Saturday, and I gave them this illustration that you are going to say to Brother Shegun Kingsley that Brother Shegun Kingsley will not see you in church for 2 Sundays. And Brother Shegun Kingsley goes, oh, Pastor Leke, I joined you, sir. This is your preaching. This is your topic. In fact, I also get my offering online. Now, because Pastor Shegun Kingsley spent £20 to come to church on a Sunday, to and fro, so he feels that instead of giving £20 in church, let him add the 40, make £20 to make £40 in offering, which will help the church. So he decided to stay back at home and watch the service. So how do Pastor Leke now come back and tell Pastor Shegun he's not in church because I didn't come physically when I've joined you? It's a big question that I don't know how we're going to be able to get around it. And one of the reasons why I brought you on this thing, sir, I'm going to round up now, is that long before now,
yes, sir,
I've seen us go around with the General Vassia, our father, to some even remote places. And I know that I will mention the other thing that you look for. You look for two things immediately. The second one is between us, sir. It's between us, sir. But the first thing you are looking for is that you're looking for internet, you're looking for data, you want to get online like yesterday, ASAP. And if you don't get that, you're not settled. The next morning, I see you projecting and we're doing open heaven, and you are showing this to everybody all around the world. Confession, sir. I felt that, where is Pastor Leke troubling us? I feel that, allow daddy to rest. Allow us to, we are going to do some running around. But then, my big question now is that, has Holy Spirit spoken to you that this is the next church? Is it just that you are doing your things that you just want to? Because I have seen you do this online church in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And I'm not making mouth about it. I'm not sure that any one of us actually have an idea of what you have been doing. Not 1 year, not 2 years, not 3 years, not 4 years ago, how you take two mobile phone. I remember we went somewhere and they were having problems with their with their recording system, and you quickly set up your phone and you started recording and you were sending it to Dove Media and all the stuff. And so my question is, is it that Holy Spirit has spoken to you, to our daddy General Vassia, or is it that you have just survey, or you just have an idea that this is where the church is going, sir?
Hey, Holy Spirit will have to help me on this one. Okay. So, Pastor, thank you for the honor. Thank you for the privilege. And we commit everything. We're tapping into your 21 days of fasting and prayer, that anointing will spread over to what we are doing here today, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, the thing is this, sir. I don't even know where to start. The world was going to have to shift anyway. The shift was coming. The change was coming. But thanks to God Almighty that we seem to have been preparing over time for this, so it didn't hit us as a slap in the face immediately. I can give a billion and one examples. We do a morning devotion with Daddy Gio, you know, our father in the Lord, Pastor here, the way, for, you know, he speaks of all of 25 minutes. In that 25 minutes across the world, Facebook lets us know that there's an impression, or people that same someone has contacted or reached, or that morning devotion has reached, of over 169,000 people.
Whoa.
In the space of, so now,
whoa,
even if we gather all those people All of them can't fit in into his prayer room. His prayer room might take maybe 50 people at most. All of them are not just in Nigeria. I mean, one of the days, he even prayed his final prayer in Yoruba. And I had to quickly whisper to him offline that the English people, sir. So he quickly, you know, continued an English version of the same prayer. Now, you know, when the Bible says that Jesus will come back and the whole world will see him, I've always wondered about that. How would that be possible with different time zones, with different ways of people living and all of that? So if Jesus was to appear now somewhere, he can, somebody can pull out their phones. Many people will even pull out their phones on wherever they see him in the sky and go live. So that way, everybody around the world will see him, regardless of time zone or regardless of wherever they are. And the technology is building up to that same stage, just the same way. So every tool, because John the Baptist lets us know that nothing is given to man except it's given from above. Everything that is here is given from above for a purpose. So it now depends on us, which where do we want to use it and how do we want to use it. The things that I've seen with the way the Bible, the way the you know the virus has affected us positively is more people are now pushing to work together in unity in terms of church. Now I've seen a song that was posted out in England, and it's called The Prayers or something like that, or The Blessings. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, you see that they now start posting the different churches on there. I didn't even know there's so many churches across board. So now people are drawn to focus on God. The bit that we now need to still capture their work on is to ensure that everybody is working on the same book, the same Bible, the same truth, and that same level of understanding, holiness, purity, focus on God's word, love, miracles, and, you know, things along those lines, and not just, you know, sit on one side of it. One of the people that was on that video is on this chat and is commenting. So now we have work, sir, but then at the same time, this lockdown has created an opportunity for us to actually go back to the basics, go back to the beginning. One of my guys that we went to school together called me about 3 weeks ago. He said his dad is about 82, 83. He was sick already for something else, went into the hospital. While he was there, he caught the virus. So he called me and said, he knows his dad is, you know, his dad is elderly, but that he remembered one guy that he went to uni with, and that's me. So now I've left uni almost 18 years ago now. And so, but he says, remember then I used to push them, guys, let's just quickly touch one church on the Sunday now, just come with me. That he now realized that in the middle of all of this darkness, he remembered that there was one light somewhere that I remember back in the day. He said, he has never asked me for anything, but please pray for me now, and pray for my father. That if his father will come out, and then anywhere I want him to go to, he will still, because he feels that there's a lot he hasn't shared with his dad or anything. So, of course, you know, I know I needed the power and the backup, so I informed my boss as well. And, you know, we prayed, and his father got healed. And then die, you know, even at that age. Yeah. So he calls back now and he says he's ready. And see that nobody needs to even tell him anything again. If whatever I tell him is what he's going to follow, because he sees that this thing now works. How did we communicate? WhatsApp, because obviously he didn't call me directly or anything. So the same technology. Now the church has to now run through this system and be deliberate about everything we are doing. You will not have everybody come to church. People are even doing Sunday service shopping. Service shopping. Let me explain what I mean by service shopping. So you can have multiple devices. And then at the same time, you go, okay, I'll pick Dove and see what RCG TV is doing. And then I'll quickly jump from there, see what Jesus House is doing. You can even do different time zones if you want, depending on which one you are feeling happy with. Then you will go to House of the Rock. Then you can go to Mountain of Fire. Then you can go to anybody else you want to go to. Immediately you get there, which is now where the pastors are going to have to walk at that. Oh God, it's going to be so sweet, because I've been waiting for that part. The minute you get there and your sermon is not on point, sir, they can't, it's not even, they don't even have to beg them. See, sir, you know, like you said, I carry multiple devices. I have all sorts of devices. I have a device here. I have devices all over the place. I will still show, if I have to mark attendance that I'm coming to your church, I will still leave this one I'm using on. But at the same time, I can have my two other twins just sitting beside this one and just be jumping, you know. I have Bluetooth earpieces, multiple Bluetooth earpieces, so I can connect this one to another one and then just be there. I'll just be shaking, even if you're looking at me, I'll just be shaking your head. But I'm listening to other people as well. So now, you know, there's some men of God that can't do anything except they have the crowd there. So there are someone is encouraged or gingered, as we say in Nigeria here, by the reaction of the crowd. But then now you need to go back to God so that every single sermon is coming from God, especially when you now have the big hitters, as you might want to put it, that are already preaching at the same time. So everything you bring now has to be authentic between your own relationship, between you and God on what you are delivering. Mm-hmm. And then now you now have to now practice the miraculous over this medium. Because, go back to the word where he says he sent his word and his word was able to reach them. So I should be able to lay hands on somebody over Instagram and they to receive their healing on the other side. So I'm not just doing things the regular ways anymore. I should be able to pray for you from here and, you know, the Holy Spirit will transfer and touch you wherever you are across the world. Now, the church, the church has to be deliberate. If we are preaching in the service, regardless of who you are talking to, so the pastors, as they trained us in Bible college, the message has to be to you. So you are also preaching to yourself. So ignore the crowd now. So everything you are saying, you are saying it to yourself. You are also saying it to your own family, to experience you are going through. Mm-hmm. And if you are doing praise and worship, you keep the viewer online in mind. Mm-hmm. Every single way, and assume that this thing is not one, is recorded. This thing is going beyond you, so it is not just your own people alone. Somebody might just be passing through another friend's page and realize that the friend is watching a live session and click on it. And then from there, so you have to then make sure that your approach is towards everyone, not just one particular zone. So, you know, your references cannot be limited to just those people that are from Orile Gomu or those people that are from Jos or wherever else. So now you have to make sure that whatever you're referencing is simple, is across board. Your message delivery is able to reach everybody, regardless of whatever walks of life that they're in. And then of course, if you are doing something in the church, if you are giving offering, you have to then please make it easy for those who are also going to be giving offering online. Immediately, some people have a small, you know, this generation that are coming behind, their attention span is probably 15 seconds, if not even lower. Maybe your own generations, their attention is longer, you know, you are even... My generation or the generation below, nobody is doing 21 days dry fasting for everybody else to say that God should heal them or stop the virus. No, 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 no. If they are fasting either for their own self or due to lack of food at home. So, so that's just the pure honest truth. So in that world, everybody's for themselves. And they'll tell you now that they are coming from an emotional state of mind. So they can't do certain things that would stress them. You know, I can't deal. That's the way, you know, they will drop it. I can't deal, so I have to move on. But so we are dealing. Because we understand where we are coming from. We understand the spiritual levels that, you know, life goes through. And all of that. So we are ready at every time for us to keep pushing. And we are thinking ahead, sir. We are thinking constantly. We're thinking what is going to happen after this. Some generations or the younger generation are going into this blind, God forgive me, without knowing that you need to use this opportunity of the lockdown to reset. And then start to build again. God, where am I in this? Where am I? Pastor, I'll give you, this is free example, sir. And I don't know, for the viewers too, sir.
Okay.
So now I'm studying the markets like no man's business. Because when there's a depression, generally, when there's an issue, it's an opportunity for other people to be able to, you know, gain. Mm-hmm. To turn it around. oil draw to negative. There are people that are paying people to collect oil off them. I'm like, ah, oh God, opportunity. So I'm looking for where I can buy shares. I'm looking for where I can even buy oil myself. We that we didn't have opportunity before. This is how we will get rich, hopefully. I'm looking at, you know, I'm speaking to everybody. Since nobody can claim they have appointment now. So all the men of God that have been trying to hold down all this while, I'm able to reach them. Reverend Sam, Reverend Poju, all the people that, because they can't tell me that I'm busy, my schedule is busy. No, sir. We are not going away. So let us, so, you know, I'm picking brains and trying to understand and to learn. And, you know, some of the things that I've gained from them is that a lot more people realize that people can work from home a lot more. So less people would be needed to come into work. So if you are looking for places to businesses that might come up, it will be that service industry. Dubai is already way ahead when it comes to this service industry. Mm-hmm. I met a doctor once and I asked, you are here from morning to night when you go home. When you have time to take care of even the basic things, buy fuel, wash your car, things along those lines, laundry. So he goes, no, there's an app. There are big guys that offer services where they come to your house. They will fuel it because they have this unit that, you know, carries fuel. They'll fuel your car where it is. They'll wash it where it is. And then they'll, you know, anything else you need them to do, they can always do for you. So that's the service thing. And it's working in our own simple, humble Lagos now. You have companies that are into people that do deliveries by bike. So you invest in that company and the bike people, obviously they'll pay you back, but they're doing deliveries all over the place because people are no longer moving anywhere anymore. The really rich people are not even going to go to work for the next 1 month because some are saying that when Noah landed the ark finished after the storm, that they sent doves out. So those who are going now, they are doves. They are waiting for those doves to bring stick that is all clear, then you can come out. So some people won't leave home. So there's obviously the opportunity for services to happen, even across this, our own great nation, Nigeria. And then, you know, when we still bring it back to church, if you are giving offering, make it simple for those who are online. You need to actually have an online pastor. That's the way I see it, online pastor. The job of the person is the one that would welcome everybody, just like how you were, you know, speaking before I came on, ask how they're doing. I tell everybody, if we are, depending on which medium we're using for the online service, guys, please mute your mic or mute your video or whatever. We're about to connect. Yeah, your volume, all of that. We're about to connect. Guys, I hope you are good. If anybody needs counseling in advance, this, you know, this is the number. You can always just text. If we need to mark attendance, maybe there's some sort of Google app or option that allows you to say, please just click here so we know you are okay or you're in service today. If you need someone to come and visit you at home, things along those lines. So even to the point where when they give, when you make an altar call or say if there's anyone that wants to give their life to Christ. Now, the online version would be able to reach out to them that if you're trying to understand what this means or you made that decision, please click this link that we are posting up right now on your page. So they'll click it and they are dealt with and handled, like, you know. So this will be someone's job. It won't be that. I mean, I work with a lot of youths, so we are able to wiggle around and work around things. So, but it will be absolutely deliberate. If you know that you won't be able to make service next week because you don't have enough data or you don't have internet, let us know so we can send you funds to be able to clear that side. If you're having difficulties with food at home or you have, you know, things along those lines so that you actually prepare for that audience like it's another church entirely. Mm. Right now, sir, Pastor, we have 100 people on here watching this right now. Between you and I, sir, you know there's some parishes in UK, sir. In the last 6 months, in the last 1 year, they don't reach 100, sir. There's nothing. The pastor has preached, he has fasted, he has spoken tongues, he has not, but the people just would not come. Maybe, I don't know, maybe it's his English, maybe it's the location, maybe it's the timing, maybe it's whatever they are offering and all of that. So, someone is sending a message that please, pastor, this life can be saved onto your profile for the next 24 hours. We need to rewatch it, sir. Yeah, I mean,
I saw it as well. What we are going to do is that once we finish here, We're going to load it on YouTube. We're going to load it on Facebook.
On YouTube,
so anybody that wants to go through it, we just be available for them. Thank you, sir. Go ahead, sir.
Yes. But then, Pastor, there's a part that is still human. We like to still gather. We like to see other people. We still like to connect. So people will still come to church. But then our church needs to now be prepared. If the rules will be, you can't enter a place of worship without a mask or a glove. So church will go in advance. So I was watching. So I watch all news, sir. I watch, if I wish I can turn around my screen for you. I have one screen behind us and I have another one to the side. The job of the side one is just display all the news and you mute it. I also have Google that is preset. Every time I tell it, I'll just say, okay, Google, and then I'll tell it up. It will just start dropping all the news from across the world, reading it to me one by one and all of that. One of the news today is that in Japan, or is it South Korea, that they are playing their baseball matches again, but without the fans. And I noticed something. The coach came into the place to do an interview like he would, and his jacket was the club's jacket. His face mask, too, was designed to match that. So when people are coming to the church, and you have to, so you create them a face mask that is specially made for the church, you know, that they can keep. You can even secretly write a number on there so that they can always reach you in case, you know, of anything after and all of that. So, you know, we have to also, we obviously people will still gather. People have to gather. People want to do their weddings. I want everybody to be there. No woman will go and pay for all that expensive clothing and then still now say that they don't want people to turn up. Even if it's 20, let them see. I want them to see my wedding. They must come to my wedding. So.
Wow. So, my problem is this, sir.
Yes, sir.
I thought we were going to do this for 1 hour, but you have now got to open some things that we will still do it for 1 hour, no doubt, but I think we may have to do this again. Because the problem now is that, like I said to you quite a number of times, I felt, or I always feel I'm a futuristic thinker, but now you blew the mind again to another level. So now, number one, you know me, I have never been a techie person per se. Even Facebook, I don't do before now. But now, I'm now on Facebook, you can be sure, I'm open Instagram, I'm everything. So I want to learn. In fact, each time I'm challenging myself on this, I'm looking at my wife, I'm looking at you, and you know, all those things that every one of you do then that doesn't really make a meaning to me. Now it's making a meaning. But then there's something, few things you say, the revolution beats. It's coming to church. I think I am 100% also into that. No doubt about it. But you hit a little bit of a hard nut, sir. And that's saying that the miraculous will also be taking place via the online church. And I agree with you. And I agree with you because, again, you know, people have come to me to say, Pastor Kingsley, blah, 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 blah. And I've called you to say, look, these people have come. Can we just, at daddy's prayer time, can we get it, daddy, to just pray for them online? Even though some people, you and I know that some people will say, no. Daddy must put hands on my head. We've had some people who have brought out their faith to daddy's prayer over the phone. And whether we like it or not, that's a medium. That's a media. That's it. Number one, it's a media prayer. It's a medium prayer. It's a virtual prayer. It's an online thing. It's just that there's a voice. So, my problem now is...
Pastor, I can help you with that.
Before you answer, my problem now is, sir, even in the physical, I am not operating in the miraculous.
Yes, sir.
I don't have faith for the miraculous. I don't try it. I don't even know anything about it. Now you are now telling me to go into the miraculous online. Number one, a bit of a challenge. You need to help me, help all the viewers. That's number one. Number two, things that you said that blew my mind open is that, do I know that there's a change in church? I agree. Do I know that there's a shift completely from what we used to have? I agreed. But what you're now saying to me, and I said this jokingly to the young man that is the brain behind all of this, himself and his team in City of David.
Yes.
Because I have no clue of all of these things. But there's a young man that Chiji, that God of Heaven is using.
Yes.
Now, what you are now, and I missed, I just said it jokingly to him this afternoon. I said, Chiji, you are now the pastor of the church. If you ask every one of us to jump, we will jump. If you ask, because now, well, is it there very spiritually? No. But he's the one connecting every one of us. He's the one saying, this is what we should do. Now, you now said something, sir, which I need more light. That
Yes.
it is not just that we will do this and we'll be doing an online, that we need to now have an online pastor.
Yes, sir.
Please let's rewind and play a little bit. Because I think a lot, I've been thinking what's going to happen, what church is going to be like, but I
Yes.
know everything's going to go online. And I've said to people, what the church is going to become now is that one of the major reasons why people will still be coming to church is because of social gathering and social interaction. You can't take that away
Yes.
from people. So now that means
Yes.
that the pastor also now have to look at how we are going to make the church much more impactful towards socializing. That's another ball game entirely. But then I need this part of having somebody who is purely, even though I said it jokingly, but I didn't see it in a massive way that you have said it this afternoon that look, it's not just going to be that we are doing online. Somebody has to
Okay.
be like an online pastor that is actually attending to the people as the church is going on, even when the church has resumed back. Can you please shed more light on this for us? And while you are saying this, I need you to understand that there are some of us that has just 10, 15 members in church.
Yes, sir.
There are some that have 50, don't even have the 100, and don't have that kind of a facility. Then where are we going to be? One of my daughters have actually said online pastor Shiji, so he's laughing. Over to you, sir.
Okay. So Pastor, one of the things that that one of our youth pastors we talked about was that this gives us an opportunity to restart all over again.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So we have to do believers class from scratch. Teach people what it means to believe in God. Teach people what it means to have given your life to Christ. And then, just the basics, the ABC of Christianity. You know, you accept, you believe, you confess. Now, the part where you were meaning, where you said that people will now have to believe that they can receive their miracle through this medium, purely by faith. I can teach people. Don't let me. I believe people can be taught faith to another level by a million and one examples, by testimonies, and then what we've also seen, because the Bible says faith cometh by hearing the word of God. So it didn't actually say that they physically have to. It didn't say it's by seeing or by touch. It is purely by hearing. So if people can hear, which is the most important part, then you can walk their faith. Now, I've met a lot of people. Some people have come. I want to see Daddy Joe. I want to see Daddy Joe. I need to see. I have to be on a mountain. And brother Cyril here from mainland Europe is telling us the centurion exactly. So that was somebody that understood what faith was. It was just inspired in him that I'm a man that I give orders and I also receive orders. So he believes that words out of the mouth of God, they are spirit. So they can always move even faster than you can. But you just have to let the individual know that if you would hold God accountable and hold everyone accountable, that faith can definitely work without any issues. Now, the thing is this, oh God. Once we teach faith, that one is it removes all doubts. Now individuals are able to connect more. Individuals can see. And then once we are able to also share our testimonies by real people, not the ones we read out every Sunday, but by real people, that those people are actually sharing it themselves. They send their 1 minute clip, they send whatever it is that they need to send to us. We play it online, share with other people. It would build their faith beyond anything else.
Yes,
and it's easy to also connect. Now, a lot of people would have called in. A lot of people that preferred that Daddy Joe needs to lay hands on them. Now they know that there's no opportunity for this meeting. So some of them would just settle for, please let me just leave my name. Let him just mention my name and I'll receive it. So now, but then you can also help build their faith. I remember a guy once that came and said that he wanted prayers, that he has his passport, is about to travel abroad. But he's going for, I don't know what he was going for. He said he just got his passport and he wants to see Daddy Joe. And I was like, well, he's gone in now. There's nothing we can do. But it depends on your level of faith. He said, I will do anything. I said, see, that's his car. There's an opportunity. There's a chance that he has touched the door to open the owner's corner and enter. So he took his passport and he went to rub it on the owner's corner. So about, I don't know, 4 months later, he messages me from New York and say, oh, I'm now in New York. And I'm like, eh. So you just forgot that I was here. I remember where I saw you, and where I saw you, now you are in New York and everything. He said, I just wanted to thank you because that, since he touched his passport on that place, everything changed for him. You know, his place of work and everything. So now, when you now tell, and I have, as in several testimonies, a woman called from abroad trying to get the Geo. It was not possible then. And she said that they have an operation for the daughter and was like, it's simple. We would get a handkerchief here, use it to touch the same altar where the Geo is calling to pray to God. So now you are dealing with God straight, no human connect. Once we touch it, we put it in a DHL parcel and we send it to you via DHL. And then we do that. And the lady got it. The child got healed without needing the operation. And since then, she was just, I mean, that kind of person, you can't touch their faith. They are just there permanently and they will keep working with you. So we need to obviously build faith. We need to teach people to understand the different stages of the Christian race. And then from there, we will now continue. Now, when it comes to people that have 15 people in their service, the thing with online is you can go from the big high budget people to those who have very low cost. Like now, this is just a phone on a stand and a silent environment. You can always have that. But then at the same time, you can have a situation where you would go full high tech. And someone that I know, at least one parish that I know that spends heavily when it comes to media, obviously the likes of Jesus House, I believe your church too, moving forward. And of course, my faith. And then House of the Rock as well. So, you know, in Nigeria here, I know that they, you know, really pay attention to that. And of course, House CCG too is trying to, you know, with multiple arms that we are using to work and all of that. So, but you can always, the pastor that is doing 15 can see it as his own tool of evangelism. So I'm on the group where they have RCCG pastors, country coordinators from across the whole world. And right now they're trying to learn online evangelism, not just, you know, because now it's no longer face to face. So we are all learning. Every single person is learning. So I'm learning how to work Zoom. I've not used Zoom before. I'm learning how to work Zoom. I'm trying to understand what online evangelism is about. I'm trying to understand what coding is about so that, you know, because I'm always wondering, why do we have limitations? Why do we have limitations in terms of the amount of bandwidth that Instagram has to use when it comes to data? Which other options? Somebody wrote all of this. Somebody created all of this. So obviously it's working one way or the other. So everybody must be open to learn. Some pastors are not going to learn and this will affect them. That's just the honest truth. Some people are believing they are stuck. Now, it might be difficult for some people to be able to walk through this whole process. That's why we have the younger ones. They have more energy, they're experiencing it, so we pull them together. The honest truth is that there's an army. We have a social media army that works with my humble self, with the office of the GO and all of that, and they've been at work since before all of this. Now, the thing I love about RCCG is we have to get permission for all the things we do. But the sweeter part is you'll give you permission as long as you're not asking them for any money to do it. So we'll spend our money.
We understand that, sir.
So we don't mind.
Baza, please, yes, between you and I, if they ask us that we said it, I will give behind you.
So, I mean, you mentioned as well that what do we then do with the church building, the physical building that we've paid for, and how to improve the experience that people get when they come to church. So it won't just be church as usual anymore, because now people are coming to actually come into a place where they can see, physically see other children of God and everything. So then we now have to engage the social part. So after service, is there an opportunity for people to be able to sit down, have a coffee, play pool, still in that environment where they will know that, okay, they can connect. So I went to one church like that when I was on one of my journeys across the world.
Okay.
And I like seeing how other people do the same thing that I'm doing and learn from them. Mm-hmm. So these people they have three services every Sunday.
Okay.
Each service is an hour and a half. The 30 minutes before the next one starts is an opportunity for you to go and fellowship with other people, have a coffee, sandwiches, cupcakes, etc., get to know more. Now, in the middle of it, there's classes for marriage counseling before the marriage and after. And also, too, there's even a place where you can go where maybe you just lost a loved one or there's a situation so someone can counsel you, someone can comfort you, etc. So, I mean, you can do that for the 1.5 hours so that you don't miss the service. And the time. Before in the past, now, we'll go to church and the spirit will just catch pastor. Our pastor will just be there, spirit. The online, it is 1 hour, sir. Our Instagram is 1 hour. So, pastor, everything, let the spirit be inside this 1 hour. You know, 1 hour. So walk with us. If you want, we can do the praise and worship, remove all the extra fats so that the word can be solid. And then, you know, now you're sharing multiple information at the same time. You can quickly share your announcements, even at the beginning or whatever. So you walk inside the structure so as to maximize the bit where you get to share the word, where you get to pray and all of that. So you just keep it plain and simple, as much as possible. So now, those are the changes that I kind of like and look forward to. So when the pastor comes, he's coming hard. He's not each line. They might do a 3-course meal. Start with a starter for us. Give us the hard one and give us the sweet bit at the end, so that you can actually remember. You are not just doing anything off. So when people now actually physically come to church, then you'll be able to create those rooms, a place for somebody that wants to ask questions about, I don't know, you know, example, pastor, there's this bed, I don't know how I will propose, or whatever, I need to win my mom over. I'm sorry, I just lost a loved one, and it's really, really affecting me. I didn't cry at the burial, I don't know why I didn't cry. Things like that, or, oh, my wife is down there. I'm supposed to be in service today, but the way she was abusing me all the way since last night to now, I might go and praise God. So, I mean, someone can then, you know, work with you through that process, and then you can still come down, and you'd have already pre-healed. So the church is actually almost like a service center for a car. So you have an option. It's either you get a full wash, you get to change your engine oil, or you're checking the tire pressure and the gauges, or getting new tires and everything. So we are now, you know, reviewing ourselves to become a full package for the future, for those who are physically there and those who are also online. And then we now keep it. So Facebook recently hired a lady that our assignment was to do to cater for the churches, the faith-based organization online, and to understand their needs so that they are able to provide a lot more facilities for them beyond just streaming a service. So inside there, they are able to create cell groups of people that have the same interest. Now, the pastor's seed family that I'm part of already also have cell groups for people that have the same mindset and all of that. So people that are into photography, people that are into fashion, people that are into movies, so that even after service, there's a cell group that I feel fits into. So we can even keep interacting across the whole week. It's not just that Sunday, Sunday, Sunday. Someone is asking, must church service be for just 1 hour? No, it doesn't have to be, but the cocoa part, the concentrated part, so that outside of that, with those cell groups and those parts that you are part of, then you guys can even discuss further and be able to, chew this heavy main course that pastor has dropped at you, and even make references to it. So during this lockdown that we have now, we've locked down the community which we are in. I reference it as the New Jerusalem. Some people call it Redemption Camp. So I started cycling with just two people. Normally, it would be with my children, but start cycling with two people. Ended up with about 25 guys at the end of it. So everybody has the assignment. I didn't even know. Apparently, my own gifting is to ability to gather people once I start doing. Another person's ability is to manage those people that I've gathered. So we have one guy, Ogafemo. So he's managing them, created the WhatsApp group. Now, inside of that is, we're identifying those who have different strengths. Apparently, there's a guy that is one of us that is also, he does this thing professionally for different companies, Dangote, etc., different people, banks, etc., where he develops their staff. He does this coaching thing to bring the best out of their staff. So now I have all guys from all manners of works that live within the camp cycling with us just so that, exercise or show off or whatever reason. We cycle to the new arena where we know that everybody is tired. Once we get there, Mama Idausa's daughter is also on here. Once we got to the place we were cycling to, 12K to get there uphill, everybody was tired. Nobody could move anywhere. As we sat down, he gets up, he starts to share the word with us. Just very, two Bible passages. And then, he starts to hit it off and challenging guys and things like that. And we learned a lot. I wouldn't even lie. Even I learned a lot. I've never seen that Bible passage before in my life, and I've been trying to read the Bible, so I didn't even know it was there. It basically talked about God holding back the ability for the children of Israel to be able to take over the land, because he said that the animals there are too much. So if all of you pour out immediately, they will, circle you and eat you up. But if I release you slowly, you're able to drive them step by step. So it means God is not going to give you the ability to, won't release you quickly until you are also able to develop yourself over time so that you can, accumulate more. He said if someone was to give him $100 million now, he would not know what to do with it. So he would blow it. But then slowly but surely, if you start with 1 million, to 10 and things along those lines. So we are able to share with that group. So that's another mini cell group. And we are still keeping the same thing. We are cycling, we're having fun, everybody's showing skills. Those who fell, those who got up are still getting up. Those who those who passed out halfway through, passed out, thank God there's a car coming. Those who always make excuses, magically join us along the way somewhere, which we know somebody's dropping them off with a car. We still accept them as they are. But that's our own mini cell group from that. So the church will obviously have to get to that kind of level as well to accommodate other people. But the thing is, the ministers have to learn, the daddies have to learn, the mommies have to learn. Everybody needs to go back to the drawing board, understand what their own strengths are, and work on that strength, and move from that stage. So I don't know if you have any questions for me, or if I missed out any of the other
No,
questions.
you're doing pretty well. You've actually just covered all the question that I actually wanted to ask. So that's even the problem now. But then, there's this bit about that I know about you. I'm sure that a lot of people do not. I heard somebody saying that while the thing was going on, say, oh, but I didn't know Pastor Luke is as deep as this. And I laughed because sometimes when you try to come down to the level of even the 5-year-old boy or girl around you, anybody who doesn't work with you closely, who doesn't know you, would take it for a ride. Like you know, I for one, anytime I hear my oga.
Reverend Yemi is here, Pastor. Reverend Yemi just signed, you know.
He's coming on Thursday.
Ah, oh God, Reverend Yemi.
That's my point, sir. You know, anytime I hear my oga, I just know. Now, I'm surprised. And a lot of people, and if anybody asks me, as I thought about this, what I wanted to do over the next 3 days is to have you today, have Revy on Thursday, and then bring a group of people in their 40s, which is my group, bring the 20 people, which, 40 upward in my group, then bring the 20 group and bring the teen group, and then match the three group together so that one will feel their pulse on this, on this new stuff that we are going into, and what their expectations are, so that at least while we have said,
Pastor, mommy Mary McCauley too is here. Oh God, this is next level. You put me to be able to be among the next level people. So I'm coming. Just before you.
Okay, mommy Mary McCauley says we should leave room for question. Well, mommy, you can type your question. We pick it up. So what I'm trying to say now is this, sir. So I'm trying to bring all those three groups together so that we can have a feel of their pulse, so that we know how to get ready for the church, where we're not just talking, but we are also acting. But I'm particularly amazed when you now said, you know, the first thing I got to learn on this whole thing was Zoom. Now, again, I'm just learning. In fact, sir, this is the first time I am doing anything on Instagram.
Are you serious? This is a fantastic. Welcome, sir. Welcome, sir. Really nice.
That
sir.
Means that we all have to learn. We just all have to learn.
Okay.
My team just put me on Facebook last week. Oh my God, somebody's abusing me here. He said, Pastor, your group is in 50s.
Oh God.
So Pastor, I want to say a big thank you. I'm waiting if any question comes up on board so that maybe Mommy Mary McCauley, we can bring it up. But then the question now is this, to all pastors here, okay?
Okay, yeah. She's asking a question. She said that she goes, where do we teens fit into all of this? That was what was actually going through my own mind. Any provision for the teenagers? Now, is there a Microsoft team, as in for those who, for the cell groups that church will eventually have to create? Well, that one is, Pastor, you know, that one is directly to you, sir, that they want a Microsoft team in the church cell groups that you're going to create. For the teens, I wouldn't say that I have, I'm still learning, because one of the things that I try is to, you have to be able to relate to people, because the generation below you is maybe, especially if they have their phone, maybe 15 seconds is pushing it. So I have a 2-year-old going on 3, I have a 4 going on 5, and a 7 going on 8. And then the way they work is this: if you want peace, you have to have a bowl in the middle of the dining table, and everybody will serve their devices inside. You see how quickly they will eat that food, just so that they can get back onto it. But then, you know, we try to also engage them. But the thing is, one has to understand what they're actually going through, or else you are not able to catch their attention. If I don't actually drop down and come to their own level and fully go and see what the challenges are, what the opportunities that they have are they being exposed to, what decisions do they have to make, then you lose them. Because the only way, Pastor, you're able to reach some certain groups of people or some guys that you have around you is because you're addressing what they are going through. So now, to some people, Instagram is old. So it's either Snapchat or TikTok. So now the challenge would be, how would you have a social media pastor or team, because you need a full team now, that is across all of this, and you're able to do things that are relevant to every single person? It's work, sir. It's work. But our own social media army, there's about, I don't know, I think about 7 in, and you know, yeah, people are going. So I'll give you an example. You know how long it took them to allow us to use drone during Holy Ghost service? Drone. You know, I used to have one drone. I sold my drone. I sold my second drone. They say, hey, the thing is always distracting, it's making noise. Then they now saw some of the video shots that, you know, he gave, you know, and they're like, okay, let's take it in. Now, they've bought their own and all this stuff. But I think it's actually working out with people that are, you know, that synergy that is needed across all the leaders, for people that are specialized in areas of the teenagers, for people that are even in different ages. Open Heavens today talks about rapture. And I'm, you know, I have me, and then I have
We have 3 more minutes, sir.
3 more minutes, okay. So I'll hit it, sir. So I have myself, I have my wife, and I have the 3 children. I cannot read to them the teenage Open Heavens or Daddy Joe's one and just leave it by what I read. I need to break it down according to those Bible passages that have been given and explain it to them. And now they say they want a video that has to do with rapture so they can understand the full idea of rapture. We even prayed that prayer of salvation again today to the 2-year-old, 3-year-old one, so that they understand what is coming. And we watch Passion of the Christ, and we now go and watch a movie about rapture so that everybody's ready.
Wow.
Yes.
Well, that's another bit that a lot of people do not know about you. Even though you travel so much, you are indeed a father to the core to my lovely children. Thank you so much, Pastor Leke, for this.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Appreciate you. Please greet Mama for me and tell her that she may not be aware of this, that anytime I'm coming back to London, I always buy these. So.
Oh, wow. Really strange. Nice one. I'll put the plug in. They are there. You can order at any time. Mimis is there, sir. Mimis .ng. They are on Instagram.
Okay.
Yeah, so they are on there, sir. They are on there. It's NG or something like that. Right. .ng.
So
they are there.
Thank you so much. We might bring you back again because you have definitely 1,001 unfinished job. thank you so much, my father. Truly.
No, Pastor, thank you, sir.
More grace, thank more you, anointing.
Amen.
All the guys
Amen.
In protocol are all online. They are sending their to their boss. Thank you so much, sir.
No, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. God bless you, sir. Have a good one.
Is Pastor Titi around? She wants to say hello to her.
Babe, they want to say hello to you, so come and wave. I think Pastor has maybe like a minute left, so babe, please come and wave. And Pastor, please, you need to, when you're closing out, you need to share a word of prayer for everybody, especially people that are going through all sorts in this season, so that, you know, we won't leave the people without the prayer, because the prayer will take them higher and take them further, and their light is able to shine. Babe, please come say quick hello before Pastor runs out. You just wave. You just wave, just wave, just wave, just wave, just wave, just wave. Just wave. Just wave. Say, for you.
God bless you. Okay, let us pray. Father, we want to thank you.
Thank you, Lord,
for the life of your son that you have endowed you. So much. Thank you for the grace that you have made him to be in this generation. We thank you for everybody that has joined us on this platform. Lord, yes, we Lord. Ask that you will cut this word. not just to
Amen.
Give word to us, but a seed to us that will germinate in our life and will become profitable to us in the name of Jesus. And we are using this time again to speak, oh Lord, into the life of everybody who are trusting you for one thing or the other in this period, that the high hand of God, the scripture call it the everlasting hand. In the daytime, it was a pillar of